Hello, this is Javad Hamidi, co-founder of TATBIM. In this video, we will learn how to model folded plate structures in Revit. So let's go. Okay, guys, maybe you have seen this kind of structures in your project or in your ideas, but you have thought maybe it is too difficult and time-consuming to model this kind of structures in Revit. But actually, this is really, really easier than you think. And you can model them maybe in less than a minute in masking environment that we are going to do that right now. Okay, you can do this kind of things and model this conceptual form in project environment or family environment. For this tutorial, I will use family environment to have a better look to our form, okay. Let's go to the family and click on new on my English and conceptual mask. Metric mask would be a good environment for this kind of modeling. Click on open and let's create our folded plate structure. Okay, to start that, you need reference lines to place your profiles. For example, if you want a shape with two profile, you need two reference lines. Or if you have more profiles, you should draw more profiles too. Okay, let's go to the top and create some reference lines here. Click on reference line and line. Okay, my first one here, maybe here would be a good place. And second one, let me copy it. Click on select a reference line and select on copy. Check multiple to do multiple copies. Maybe about 20 meter and another 20 meter. Okay, select it, click on copy, multiple and copy it in 20 meters, okay, 20 and 4 meters, okay. This is a regular process that you should do for all of the shapes, but the last tip would be a great feature for this kind of models. Okay, let me set the plane on the first reference line, and let's create our first profile. I use model lines to create my and draw my profiles. Okay, select line and do that. But the first step here is that you can't do that. You can't model them if you would draw your profile with line or a rectangle or something like that. You should draw your profiles with spline, curves or other kind of things, and it should be a one loop, not for example three line or five lines. Okay, let me create my profile. I use a splinter point, it would be easier. And from here, click on drawn work plane to have a better environment to create your profile. Okay, let me select here, come up. Okay, let me go to the model line and use spline through points. Now let's create our first profile. Okay, this is good for me. And now let's go and create our second profile. Let me move it a little bit for these two. Okay, let me set my work plane to the second reference line. You need to click on set, hover over your reference line and press tab to switch the reference plane. Okay, that's good. And now let's use show to have a better view of our plans. Okay, click on reference spline through points again, and let's create your second profile. Let me use this. Okay. Okay, this is my second profile. And let's create our third profile here. It is not a rule that you should make exactly like our my profile. You just need to create them as a spline or curves or other kind of non-straight lines or shapes. Okay, hover over your reference line, press tab, and let's create our third profile. Let me bring it a little bit here. Okay. And now let's set our work plan again. Again, I am going to use a spline to point to create my profile. Okay, this is good. Let us make it a little bit lower than past tools. Okay, this is my shapes. To create form, you need to select all of them and click on create form. Okay, this is a similar process that you should do all of them in your project. For example, you select all of them and then you click on create form. Okay, this is my surface that I'm going to work with. Okay, let me set our work plane on our zero level. Okay, this is a regular process. The tip here that you should convert this surface to a divide surface, and after that, the other tip here is you should put the patterns on rhomboid. Okay, let's put this on rhomboid here, and you can see the difference. But for the whole shape, you need do some adjustment here. For example, select surface, and maybe the best number for vigor is maybe 3 to 6. That would be make the exact shape like folded plate structures. For example, let me put this number on 3, and you will see the difference. Okay, this is it. You can see the form in the best way that you can model them in Revit. If you would choose the higher number in Vigrid, you will see another shape. For example, let me put it on 15 and you will see another shape, or you can change your Vigrid on, for example, 5, you will see a different shape. And also after modeling, you can change your profiles to, for example, I press tab here to select profile, click on edit profile, and let us edit our profiles a little bit. For example, bring this down like this, and you will see the difference in your shape too. Let me undo it and click on finish. Okay, this is a good one. But we can make it a little bit more realistic too with some patterns. Okay, let me put it maybe on 20 here. And here, let me put it our rigid on 4. This is my favorite shape now. Okay, the next is to create another pattern with rhomboid shape to convert this conceptual form to a model. Okay, let's go to the file menu, click on new and new family. We need a curtain panel base here. Okay, go to the English folder and select your metric curtain panel pattern environment. Okay, let's go to the open tab, change your pattern type to a rhomboid. From here, select rhomboid, and after that we are going to create a simple shape here. Select all of the reference line and click on create form. I need a surface. I don't want a volume. I need just a surface. Okay, and you also can change the material here too. Okay, let us put, for example, on a ceramic or on a fabric or other things that you will like. And also you can do advanced patterning, advanced patterns too. For example, you can create structures for it and other kind of things that you can do in patterns environments. But for this tutorial, I'm not going to do that. So let's create another material here, and let's change it on maybe ice white or navy blue. And let's check our user render appearance. Okay, let's load this on our project. Okay, after that you can select your project, your form, and switch the pattern to your family. It will make it more realistic. Okay, let me change it. Can see the difference here, and it will give you a little bit more realistic form that you will see in the previous form. Okay, this is very good for me, and it is really, really easy to model these kind of structures in Revit. And after that, because this is parametric, you can change all of the parameters. For example, let me change this to maybe 3. You can see the difference in a second, or maybe 2. It will change the whole form, and it will dissolve your shape. So keep it above 3 to 8 would be a nice number for V-grid. For example, let me put it on 4, and you can see the form here.